Let me first introduce myself. I am Dr. Kumudini Pati, an independent researcher associated with the Center of Women's Studies, University of Allahabad. And today we are taking up the subject of women's studies, paper 15, The Stories the States Tell. This is module 16, which discusses the contribution of Geeta Mukherjee, the architect of the Women's Reservation Bill. Geeta Mukherjee was a member of parliament from Panskura constituency of West Bengal. She belonged to the Communist Party of India, and she had been a member of the Legislative Assembly from 1967 to 1977, which is a long 10 years, and she had won the Panskura Purba assembly seat 4 times consecutively. She was also elected a member of the parliament for 7 consecutive terms, and she remained in parliamentary struggles for a long period of 33 years. Now we will discuss the contributions of Geeta Mukherjee in the drafting of the Women's Reservation Bill and her inputs in the Joint Select Committee of Parliament. Her contribution was exemplary, to say the least. In fact, she was the main architect of the Women's Bill. Not only that, she was an active campaigner for the Women's Reservation Bill, and she had resolved that she would get it passed in her own lifetime. Now we come to the contributions of Member of Parliament Geeta Mukherjee to the Women's Reservation Bill. Actually, the Women's Reservation Bill was the 81st Constitutional Amendment Bill, which was placed in Parliament in 1996. And this bill was supposed to be passed in Parliament after discussions with various political parties. So, a Joint Select Committee of Parliament was constituted. And just after the bill had been placed, it was given to the Joint Select Committee to somehow come to a consensus and then get it passed. Geeta Mukherjee was the chairperson of this Joint Select Committee. Let me tell you that this bill had come at the time of Prime Minister Devegowda, who was at that time heading the United Front government in India. Now, Geeta Mukherjee was very emotional about the Women's Reservation Bill, and she wanted somehow to arrive at a consensus, so she was also busy campaigning, lobbying, and discussing the bill with various women's organizations. But her dream could not be fulfilled, and that was because it got severely diluted during discussions. Actually, what happened was that the social justice camp, in which parties like Rashtriya Janata Dal, the JDU, the JD Secular, and also the Samajwadi Party, had started making demands for a quota within quota, that is, an OBC quota within the 33% quota for women. Then Geeta Mukherjee had to depend very much on the left parties and the Congress and the BJP to somehow build a majority, but she was unfortunately quite disappointed because she found that they were also backtracking on the bill and they were using the pretext of lack of a consensus. Then after a lot of discussion with women's organizations who had been invited to the Joint Select Committee to put forth their views on the women's bill, and let me tell you that there were 102 memoranda that had reached the Joint Select Committee. They had been sent by various women's groups, individuals, researchers, and many people who had been active with the campaign on the women's reservation bill. There were women who had signed petitions in blood, and they had sent them to Geeta Mukherjee to take it up in the parliament. Geeta Mukherjee had also tried to lobby with women parliamentary members from various parties and tried to convince them that somehow the 33% reservation bill should be passed before we discuss quota within quota. On 14th August 1997, which was the last day of the monsoon session of Parliament, somehow Geeta Mukherjee had an opportunity to occupy the chair. It was in the absence of the Speaker and the Deputy Speaker that she got this opportunity. And she, when allowed to conduct business, was very serious to get the bill passed in the monsoon session. All of a sudden, as soon as she took the chair, she said that the women's reservation bill would be tabled and it would be put forward for discussion. But it is really sad that the bill was last on the list, and so it appeared as item number 24 in the list of conduct of business, and so it looked like it would not be taken up for discussion at all. So there was nothing she could do. She tried very hard to convince the other members of parliament that this was a very important subject. But at that time, the persons who were occupying the chair after her, namely Mr. Ram Naik and Nitish Kumarji, said that they had to proceed according to rules of the parliament and they could not violate what had been set as the norm of the parliamentary conduct of business. So finally, she decided that there was no way out and she would have to walk out of the house. She left with only 5 members of parliament with her because the women members were very few that day. Somehow, after making a lot of noise, she went out, and then Mr. Priya Ranjan Das Munsi, who was also representing Howrah seat of parliament from West Bengal, accompanied her, supporting her on the issue. But the BJP parliamentarian Sushma Swaraj, who had always been pro-women's reservation, somehow stealthily slipped out of the house. Now Geeta Mukherjee decided to go all over the country and start campaigning for the bill actively. So she started her move, but before she did that, she spoke to journalists outside the parliament, and she was almost in tears when she said, "When my husband died, I was brave, but today I have been reduced to tears." In her report to the Joint Select Committee of Parliament, Geeta Mukherjee had expressed some reservations or objections to the sub-reservation idea or the quota within 33% quota for women. She argued that there was no precedent or move for a general OBC reservation in either the panchayats or the legislative bodies till now, and that the problem could be solved easily without reservation if the OBC women could be put up as candidates in OBC dominated constituencies. This I am quoting from Geeta Mukherjee's report of the Joint Select Committee, 1997. Now we come to the discussions that went on the Women's Reservation Bill. The Joint Parliamentary Committee, which had been chaired by Geeta Mukherjee, had examined the bill, and it had made 7 important recommendations, 5 of which were included in the draft of the 2008 bill. These were, firstly, reservation for a period of 15 years, which was accepted. Second was including sub-reservation for Anglo-Indians. Third was including reservation in seats where the states had less than 3 seats in the Lok Sabha, or less than 3 seats for SCs and STs. And the fourth was including reservation for the Delhi Assembly. The fifth was changing the term "not less than 1/3" to "as near as maybe 1/3". So 2 of the recommendations which could not be incorporated in the 2008 draft of the bill were the first for reserving seats in the Rajya Sabha and the legislative councils, and the second was for sub-reservation for OBC women after the constitution extended reservation for the OBCs. Now, there were a number of reasons which had made Geeta Mukherjee quite confident that the Women's Reservation Bill could be passed and reservation for assemblies and parliament could become a reality. One was that she seemed to be quite sure that 33% was the right percentage, since she had experimented this in the panchayats and it had yielded great results. Women representatives, according to many reports, official and unofficial, were doing much better than the male counterparts. According to Geeta Mukherjee, if there were to be 33% reservation in assemblies and parliament, around 1,000 to 1,100 women could get elected. And she said that in a very vast country like India, are there not as many able women to come into the legislative assemblies and the parliament? This was a question she posed before the parliament. But she was feeling quite frustrated because even the Congress had started backtracking. And she said in Rediff chat, "It is a $1 million question whether the bill would be passed now, because in my utter frustration, I am hearing that even such parties who had never questioned 33% are now thinking of even agreeing to 15% or 18%. So this was quite frustrating, because actually 33% is a number which has been decided by many social scientists, and they think that it is a very determining kind of number which is essential for any community or section of people to have a say in any kind of body. So the OBC reservation question, which had not been brought to the limelight by the Congress earlier, started being raised by the party after it saw that many other parties belonging to the social justice camp had also started raising this question. Now let us know a little more about this lady, a very self-effacing, modest, sincere and dedicated person who had given up her entire life for the betterment of the common people, especially for women and youth. Geeta Mukherjee was born in a middle-class family. She had been going to school in Jessore, and Jessore is now part of Bangladesh. She was born on 8th January 1924 as Geeta Roy Chaudhary in Calcutta. And as a student, as a very young student, she had joined the Bengal Provincial Students Federation. This was in 1939. And you won't believe it, she was just 15 years old when she had joined this organization. Later, she became the secretary of the All India Students Federation. And this was in 1947. At the age of 23, and she remained secretary till 1951. Now we come to her contributions in the Communist Party of India. In 1942, Geeta Mukherjee had joined the Communist Party of India, and she was a very active member of the party. She married Biswanath Mukherjee, who was already a very established senior student leader in the communist movement. She came to the limelight during the 1945 postal workers' strike. In 1945 itself, there was a huge rally organized by the CPI in which Geeta Mukherjee had taken part. And she was the only woman speaker in that rally. She received a lot of acclaim for her speech. And in 1946, she became a member of the CPI State Committee at the early age of 22 years. Now, the Communist Party of India had become underground for some period. Even during that period, Geeta Mukherjee remained very active in the movement. And in 1964, when the party split, and then it got divided into the CPI and the CPIM, Geeta Mukherjee chose to remain with the Communist Party of India, that is CPI. So we can say that she was very loyal to the values that she upheld, and she was then elected to the National Council of the party in 1978, and then she came into the National Executive in 1981. In the 17th Party Congress, which was held in Chennai in 1998, she was elected as one of the national secretaries of the CPI. As I had said earlier, for four consecutive years, Geeta Mukherjee had remained in the Assembly of West Bengal. That was in 1967, 68, 71, and 1972. And she was representing the Panskura Purba constituency of West Bengal, twice defeating Congress, once defeating the Bangla Congress, and once defeating the Forward Bloc. Then she also got elected to the Lok Sabha from the Panskura parliamentary constituency in 1978. And she continued to represent that constituency since then. She had defeated the National Congress for five consecutive times and also the Trinamool Congress for two times. Now we come to another facet of Geeta Mukherjee's personality, and that was her commitment to the cause of women. She had been involved in the struggle for women's rights all along. In fact, she had been leading the struggles of BD workers, and she always adopted a very strong position on gender issues. Geeta Mukherjee got elected to the post of Vice President of the National Federation of Indian Women, the NFIW, which is the women's wing of the Communist Party of India. And she also was secretariat member of the Women's International Democratic Front of Berlin in 1958. She also became an executive member of the NFIW in 1965. And all this was because of her strong commitment to the women's question. The National Commission for Women in 1988 had Geeta Mukherjee on its panel. So she became a member of the NCW. In 1998, she became a member of the Joint Committee on the Empowerment of Women and its Subcommittee on the Appraisal of Criminal Laws Relating to Women. Now, we come to another major event that had taken place in 1980. This was the Maya Tyagi case in Baghpat, where a woman had been raped in police custody. Geeta Mukherjee, along with two other women leaders, had visited Baghpat, and she had been fortunate enough to be able to convince the Home Minister to accompany the team. Let me tell you that a judicial inquiry was finally ordered by the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh at that time. As an MP, Geeta Mukherjee was also part of the Joint Select Committee on the PNDT Bill. She, along with Malini Bhattacharya and Sarla Maheswari, who were also senior leaders of the party, had put in a note of dissent with the Joint Select Committee against some of the provisions which were included in the 1994 PNDT Regulation and Prevention of Misuse Bill. She was a versatile leader, I can say, because Geeta Mukherjee had a multifaceted personality. She had participated in the freedom struggle, and she had been imprisoned several times before independence and post-independence. She had also served as a member of several committees and public undertakings. She had also been member of the Committee on the Welfare of Scheduled Castes and Scheduled Tribes, and also She had been a member of the Joint Committee on the Criminal Law Amendment Bill of 1980. Geeta Mukherjee believed in international brotherhood. She felt that all the toiling people of the world were one. And so she used to visit various countries like Australia, Austria, Bangladesh, Canada, China, Germany, the United Arab Emirates, United Kingdom, USA, and the former USSR, etc. And there also she used to campaign for women's rights and also for communist values. She had a very innocent facet about her. Almost you can say that she had a very childlike kind of innocence. And so she always thought about children. She started writing books for children too. One of the books is Bharat Upakatha, Folk Tales of India, or Choto Der Rabindranath, Rabindranath for the Children. These are two important works which had been written by Geeta Mukherjee. Actually, she wanted to introduce Rabindranath Tagore to the children of West Bengal and to the children of the country. She had also translated in Bengali another classic, Naked Among Wolves. When Geeta Mukherjee passed away, it was a big loss for the left movement, for the women's movement, for the parliament, for the people of India, for the toiling masses. She passed away at the age of 76 after suffering a massive heart attack on March 4th, 2000. Just as she was preparing to leave for Aligarh for a party program. And people say that on March 3rd, just a day before her death, she had vehemently protested on the floor of the house against the decision of the Bihar governor to invite the National Democratic Alliance to form government. She was a very passionate person and at the same time, very compassionate too. As Dr. K. R. Narayanan had described her, she was a passionate and compassionate political activist. She has left a void not only in the communist movement, but also in the women's movement and in all other democratic movements in the country.